بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. Respectable Chair of the Session, honored Representative of Deputies and Gentlemen present, Assalamu Alaikum. In the meantime, you know, the title of my paper is Comparative Study between Dariya-e-Noor of Dhaka and Dariya-e-Noor Diamond of Jam. It's a long paper, so it is not possible to read out within a very short time allotted for me. So I concise the paper in making some PowerPoints, photographs. I hope this will make clear for you about main approaches in this paper. There are two pieces of diamond famous, which is found in this world named Dariya-e-Noor. One of it is in Dhaka and another is in Iran. Both of these two diamonds are what famous and most valuable archaeological object. The Dariya-e-Noor of Dhaka is now in the ownership of Photo Works, Dhaka Nawab State, under the Ministry of Land, Government of Bangladesh. Now it is deposited in the vault of Sonali Bank, Dhaka. The Dariya-e-Noor of Iran is under the ownership of Iranian government and now deposited under the custody of Al-Markazi Bank, Iran. The history, shape, health, nature and pieces of two diamonds are described here, showing some photographs. The Dariya-e-Noor means Sea of Light of Dhaka Nawab. It is the largest piece of diamond found so far in whole Bengal. The original stone is 12-18 carat and rectangular table shaped. It is of same class of Pailu by nature and pure diamond made by Indian master sandstone. Like Pailu, it was found in a mine of Andhra Pradesh, India. The Dariya-e-Noor was joined to 10 smaller pieces of diamond by golden thread. Total weight of it is about 76 carats. Dariya-e-Noor of Dhaka is remarkable for its superior brilliance and purity of color. Its present shape is suitable for use as an amulet that can be used for the embellishment of Taman or Dhram. Khaja Ali Mulla was a renowned Jamindar and mother of Nawab Sir Khaja Abdul Ghani. He purchased the diamond, Dariya-e-Noor, from an auction sale of the British in November 1852 and brought it to Dhaka. The diamond was originally in the possession of Maratha king. Afterwards, the Nawab of Hyderabad obtained it at cost of 130,000 rupees. Nawab Sir Khaja Abdul Ghani. He was the boastful owner of Dariya-e-Noor. The Nawab of Dhaka had much reputation for different department community work. Their aristocracy and opulence became adequate in Bengal because of the ownership of an important diamond like Darya Inu. Now Sir Khaja Hasanullah, he wrote in his personal diary that on 7 January 1887, he wore Darya Inu as an armlet on his right arm in combination with Oriental Darbar dress while attending a royal dinner party at Kolkata. He also published an album with the picture of him not worth his jewelry from his collection. First page of the album bears the picture of the real Nur in exact size and real color. Nawab Salimullah. The Dhaka Nawab state was declined during Nawab Salimullah and the Nawab started to take loans. In 1907, he took loan of rupees 16 lakhs and 25,000 from British government by mortgaging valuable, movable and immovable properties along with Darya Inu. At the time, the value of the diamond was assessed of rupees 5 lakhs only. After the death of Nawab Salimullah, the responsibility of Darya Inu went to the chief manager of Kotwars. It's a sketch picture. Stephen Hawat has published in this book a sketch photograph of Darya Inu during his places in the possession of the King of Persia. It could be understood from this photograph that the present look of the diamond was the same at the time. It would be relevant to mention that Maharaja Ranjit Singh to wear it as an armlet, making it further attractive by the adding two large diamonds on the two sides of the famous diamond pendant. Mughal Emperor Babur and Humayun. Prince Humayun obtained the diamond, which is now named as the Darya-e Noor of Iran, while he occupied the Agra fort in 1526 from Raja Uttam Singh, the king of Gwalior, who fought in favor of Sultan Ibrahim Lodi against Mughal and took shelter there after Sabak defeat. Emperor Babu has written in his memoirs that this splendid gemstone was the famous diamond which had been acquired by Sultan Alauddin Khilji. It is so valuable that a judge of the diamond valued it at half of the daily expense of the work. It weighed about 8 mistal, that means 320 lattice. On my arrival here, Humayun presented it to me as pestas, and I gave it back to him as a gift. Mughal Emperor Muhammad Shah. As the successor of Mughal Emperor Akbar the Great, Jahangir, Shahjahan, and Aurangzeb, Emperor Muhammad Shah was the worshipful honor of Pari Noor and Darya Noor diamond. Emperor Nadir Shah of Iran. In 1739, Nadir Shah of Persia invaded northern India, defeated Muhammad Shah and occupied Delhi. As a repayment of returning the crown of India to Mughal Emperor Muhammad Shah, Nadir Shah took possession of the entire private treasury of the Mughals, including Darya Inu, in addition of Kannur and the tip of throne. Meeting between Emperor Nadir Shah and Muhammad Shah. things of discussion between or peace between my fellow Adisha and Mahamasha. Delhi, 1739. In this meeting, it was stated that instead of returning the crown of India to Muhammad Shah, Emperor Nadir Shah would be taking the position of the Mughal treasury, including Koinur and Duriyani Nur. Maharaja Ranjit Singh of Punjab, Prince Shah Shuja of Iran, fled to Kashmir along with valuable materials, along with the Koinur and Duriyani Nur. At the time, Maharaja Ranjit Singh of Punjab, after capturing Kashmir, took over the Koinur and Duriyani Nur from Shah Shuja on 1st June 1813. Koinur as an amulet. Maharaja Ranjit Singh of Punjab adding two large diamonds on the both sides of Koinur and wearing it as an amulet. Maharaja Ranjit Singh of Punjab, to show his power and wealth, he wearing Koinur in his right arm and Duriyani Nur on his left arm. You can see that in this picture. After the war of Punjab in 1849, the British took hold the treasury of Sapat and Minor Maharaja Dilip Singh, and they took Koinur and Duriyani Nur along with other valuables in their possession. Viceroy Governor General Lord Bahadur Singh. He decided to send Koinur and Duriyani Nur along with the other valuables to the great exhibition at Hyde Park in Gangnam. The jewelers left Bombay for London on 17th December 1850. The Crystal Palace at Hyde Park, London. In 1852, the great exhibition was held in this palace. The exhibition was inaugurated by Queen Victoria. Koinur and Duriyani Nur of Dhaka was displayed here in the Indian pavilion along with other valuable objects from India. Indian pavilion in the great exhibition of Hyde Park, London. Koinur and Duriyani Nur was displayed here in 1852. Koinur diamond, now adorning the highest crest of the crown of Queen Elizabeth of British. Lord and Lady Darnley, on 6 January 1887, the Viceroy Governor General of India, Lord Darnley, accompanied his wife, came to the Baribon's Palace of the North Calcutta and observed the diamond with great interest. Lady Darnley wrote in her personal diary that the Nawab showed us some jewelry. Important Duriyani Nur was also among them as the sister of Koinur. It has immense historical and astrological value. King George V and Queen Mary. The King of England, George V and Queen Mary visited the Duriyani Nur of the North while touring Kolkata on 4 January 1912. The King was aware of Duriyani Nur beforehand and mentioned its immense historical and archaeological value. He commented that it should be preserved in a proper museum. The Duriyani Nur of Iran, during the reign of Nasiruddin Qajar, the beauty of the gemstone was enhanced by mounting it in an elaborate frame There are many small pieces of diamond and rubies have been fixed to make a wonderful border serving as a frame for mounting. Upper side of the stone is surmounted by triple conical shape of sun rising sun, which is adorned by two lion figures on the both sides of it. King Bhadrarishi of Iran, he engraved his name on the back side of the diamond, Tariyari Rubi. King Nasiruddin Qajar of Iran, during his time, the beauty of Tariyari Nur of Iran was enhanced by mounting it in an elaborate frame to give the present shape. King Nasiruddin Qajar was said to be very fond of diamond and often wearing it as an armlet or a cross. Nuru line means light of eye. Diamond of the tiara, diamond and the tiara of Empress Hara of Iran. It is said that Dariyani Nur has been cut into two pieces. Each smaller part is named Nuru line. Each one is a 60-carat. And one of the largest oval-shaped colored diamond of the world. Nuru line is adorning the center front part of the empress, Haras Tiara. Reza Shah Pahlavi of Iran. Reza Shah Pahlavi of Iran, the founder of Pahlavi dynasty of Iran, wearing the Dariyani Nur diamond as a decorating of his military cap. Muhammad Reza Shah Pahlavi of Iran. Dariyani Nur was used on the ceremonial dress of Muhammad Reza Shah Pahlavi of Iran during his coronation ceremony. Next, conclusion. Conclusion: after the abolition of Zamindari system, descendants of Dhakanov family visited over various places in home and abroad out of the need of review. Most of the jewelries of the Nawabs are almost gone into extreme. Under these circumstances, among movable properties, luckily the Dariyani Nur diamond is still belonging to us in Bangladesh. It can be understood from the discussion above the both splendid diamond named Dariyani Nur of Dhaka and Iran is not only a valuable gemstone, it has also much historical and archaeological importance. Those diamonds are the silent witness of many important and valuable chapters of the history of Indian subcontinent and also of Iran. So it is a valuable national asset. That is why those witness of glorious history of the country and nation should be preserved with the status of national prestige. Thank you all.
I think it should be for reminding you the basic difference of Dariyani Nur of Iran and Dariyani Nur of Dhaka. Dariyani Nur of Dhaka is a white, plain, crystal clear diamond. And the Dariyani Nur of Iran is a pink diamond. See, that is very, very valuable. And this is also very, very valuable. But this is, I just want to add.
And thank you. Those two diamonds are historically important.
Yes.
These are also original gemstones produced by the Indian side and found in the mine of Kallur in Andhra Pradesh, you know. So it is archaeological evidence. It is luckily that it is one of the Dariyani Nur is in Bangladesh.
But one thing I just want to make it clear, I did not know, thank you for reminding us that I did not know that Dariyani Nur of Iran was cut by the Shah of Iran.
Thank you,
thank you for that.
Mr. President, Honorable President of Algonquin Nation, Professor Dr. Abu Musa Malikullah, who gave me spoke to present a paper in this session, also last paper of this session. Thank you all.